got cargo? Yeah, you got cargo.
I got three.
Do you have coal? Do you have one that says gold? Coal? Black? Yeah. Copper? Yeah.
That's the, I guess that's the one that we have.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a green. It's two cargoes.
Mm-hmm.
And the coal.
Yeah, coal is doing that. Especially if that's a coal fire.
Well, and you know what? It's one of those that's almost worth owning for being able to access on a regular basis. My brother, I don't do this, but my brother-in-law and his family have a whole set of like holiday music movies that they just watch as a family every year.
Oh, I did. I took it back from the show.
Yeah.
Let's go see if I can find the other pictures.
This is, the battery's going here.
Yep.
Pee-pee! Lily, look. First dress is mine.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's usually cold. So I can say,
I'm never cold.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Paul Lutheran Church in Sarasota, Florida. It's great having you in person and those of you who are watching on your devices. I'm Pastor Ashley Nichols. It's great to have you here, and it's great to have guests and returners. Michelle Hilton and John McAuliffe are back. Michelle continues to serve as the VP of our Synod, so we're so happy to have you here. And we had our Mid-Gulf Conference meeting yesterday, and so she was in town for that, and so we're glad you are here back at one of your home churches always. So great having you, and a special welcome to Mackenzie Grimes as the lead organizer for the SURE organization. She'll have a temple talk shortly. She'll also be available for during coffee hour today, so remember to join us in the fellowship hall for that. Our Sunday school leader won't be leading Sunday school today. Yay! As she's heading out on a little road trip right after worship. But if you want to stay and have Sunday school and continue to have conversations like you do, you're welcome to do so. Or you can just talk to Mackenzie Grimes and hear more about Shure. So you have choices. Prayers this week, we want to continue to lift up Ginger Webb as she had back surgery. And so she remains at Sarasota Memorial Hospital, but is expected to go home maybe even today. So continue prayers that the surgery works and that she can get back into doing all that she wants to do, including get back into worship. Rick, welcome back.
Thank you. So I will begin. We only have two birthdays this week, and it's tomorrow. Marty Hillerich and Brianna Broadnax. So John, can you start us off, as soon as you get seated, can you start us off with happy birthday?
Sure. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, everybody. Happy birthday to you.
And we hope you both have a blessed day each and every day. Someone in the congregation has gone beyond senior citizen and is going to have a birthday next week. Just a small hint as to who that might be. She is so old, there is a picture of Moses in her high school yearbook. Community Meals had 44 people attending and served 98 meals this past Tuesday, and the food pantry served 85 families yesterday. So we'd like to continue to thank all the volunteers that give of their time to keep these things up and running. Pastor Ashley's e-blast this week talks about some of the things coming up in October, particularly Reformation Sunday, and a survey to take a look at where we are and where we want to go as a church. There's a whole lot more, so be sure to read it. Be sure to notice the two newly installed benches where the old ones were along the sidewalk leading to the sanctuary. These have been donated in memory of Bonnie Zip, and next week we'll have a dedication during fellowship time. There will be no Sunday school, as you know, this Sunday. Community meal at 5:30 p.m. on Tuesday. Wednesday, we have property at 8 a.m., bells at 6, and choir at 7. And there will be no St. Paul prayer Zoom titled with Talking with God on Thursday this week. Food pantry bagging on Thursday at 9:30 a.m. and distribution on Saturday at 9 a.m. And next Sunday, join us at noon in the Fellowship Hall for our version of Oktoberfest. We will be serving brats, sauerkraut, and a shrimp boil with steamed vegetables and all the fixings. Root beer, lemonade, and iced tea will be the beverages of the day. So if you haven't signed up, there is a sheet in the Fellowship Hall. And if you would like to bring a dessert, that was brought to my attention, just add that to your name. On Tuesday, October 10th, the ECLC will be having their annual Trikathon fundraiser. It starts at 9:30 until 10:30. It is open to all families. And I was going to ride, but nobody will lend me a trike. Anyways, it's more fun to watch the kids. Well, it could be a bit debatable. Come support the school and cheer on the kids. St. Paul won't be hosting a trunk or treat on the property this year since Halloween falls on a Tuesday, and it would interfere with the community meal. But there is a community event at Arlington Park that St. Paul will be at. Along the walking trail in the park, there will be stations for kids to trick-or-treat, and we will also, go to page 2, have a small craft for them to work on. This event often brings 300 kids, and so if you want to help us, we can definitely use it. It's on Friday, October 20th from 5 to 6:30. And on Sunday, October 15th, after worship, we will be putting together bags with our name on them, of course. And on Sunday, October, after worship, we will be putting together these bags to give out of the park that have treats and St. Paul information in them. We also need candy and goodies for the bags, and there will be a bin in the sanctuary and one in the fellowship to put the donated bags of candy in. So please bring your donations by October 15th, and any of the youth that help put the bags together after worship on October 15th will get to take some candy home with them. And I can see some adults pouting and wondering if they can have some candy too. They will help, so we have to earn that by helping them filling at least 25 bags. And now, an exercise for people who are out of shape. Begin with a 5-pound potato bag in each hand. Extend your arms straight out from your hides, from your sides, and hold them there for a full minute, and then relax. After a few weeks, move up to a 10-pound potato bags. Then try 50-pound potato bags, and eventually try to get where you can lift a 100-pound potato bag in each hand and hold your arms straight out for more than a full minute. Once you feel confident at that level, put a potato in each bag. When my local barista handed me my change, one coin stood out. Look at that. You really get one of these old wheat pennies nowadays, I said, tapping the sheet of wheat design. I handed her the penny, turning it over and over in her hand. She said, you know, I always thought these were made of copper. I'm sorry.
Well, thank you, Rick, and we're glad to have you back. Now we'll continue with our temple talk from Mackenzie Grimes, the lead organizer for SURE, the Sarasota United for Responsibility and Equity. It is so much easier just to say SURE. And it's a justice ministry that St. Paul participates in. It's the way congregations can work together to bring about common good for Sarasota.
Thank you. So first of all, thank you guys so much for welcoming me here. I have never actually attended a Lutheran service before, so this is going to be fun for me. Like Reverend Ashley said, my name is Mackenzie Grimes. I'm a Sarasota local, born and raised here. I went to Booker High School, USF Sarasota, 2012 as well. My family is from here. My grandparents are from here. I care about this community like I know so many of us do. The beauty about SURE is that we are an interfaith group that also cares about this community. We believe that justice is biblical. Justice is paramount to our faith. We are commanded to do justice in Micah 6:8. In Matthew 23:23, Jesus says, "Woe to you, Pharisees and scribes! You pay a tenth of your dill, your mint, and your cumin, but you neglect the weightier matters of the law, justice, mercy, and faithfulness." So SURE brings together faith organizations like St. Paul, like 12 Springs Church in the Rosemary District, like St. Andrew, the UCC Church down on in Gulfgate, and a few others as well. And we work to figure out what is going to fix our community. Justice isn't about nailing anybody to the cross necessarily, but instead about looking at the needs of our community and making sure that what we have in place is both functional as well as beautiful. We want it to work for all members of the community. What's good for the goose is good for the gander, right? So we do that by meeting and, where's Joanne? She's here somewhere. Joanne is one of our lovely team members for St. Paul. St. Paul will be having a house meeting, I believe, on the 22nd of October. If you're invited, which you all will be, please attend. It's a good way to kind of learn a little bit more about SURE and talk about what issues you've seen in your community. From there, we go into a research process, and we try and find legitimate solutions to some of these problems. And then in March, we present these solutions to our decision makers, to our elected officials, and we hold them accountable to their constituents. Not in an aggressive way, not in a way that says kind of gotcha, just in a way that says, hey, this is a need, and we would like you as the elected member that we trust to enact some kind of change for our community. St. Paul has been a member for years, I believe. And it's because of congregations like this, like St. Paul, St. Martha, St. Andrew, and the like, that we're able to kind of do this. Because churches, as much as we want to talk about doing justice, we have to face the reality that a lot of times that involves money. And churches historically don't have a lot. So instead of combating politics with money, we combat it with people. Right? The more people that are present, the more people that show up that are willing to hold people accountable for their decisions, the more chance we have of enacting real change in our community and really, really making sure that we're doing for everybody what we would want done for ourselves. So like Reverend Ashley said, I will be around for coffee after service. Please come talk to me. Please ask me questions. I have so much more information, but I don't want to take up the entire service. Thank you guys again for having me.
Thank you, Mackenzie. Yes, as she mentioned, our house meeting will be October 22nd after worship, after coffee hour. We'll stick around in the fellowship hall and have a time to share about SURE and also what's on your hearts and minds for the good of Sarasota. Are there any other announcements this morning? If not, we prepare our hearts and minds for worship with our prelude. Please rise as you are able for the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be God, the one who forms us, Jesus who bears the cross, the Spirit who makes our joy complete. Amen. Let us bow before God in humility, confessing our sin. I invite us to a time of silence and reflection. Steadfast and faithful God, you have revealed the ways of justice, yet we fail to follow you. We are overwhelmed by the world's violence and suffering. We are afraid to risk what we have for the sake of others. For the harm we have caused, known and unknown, forgive us. For the unjust demands we place on others and your creation, forgive us. For the ways we turn away from you and our neighbor, forgive us. Lead us back to you and set us on the right path. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Beloved in Christ, God's justice stretches beyond all understanding. God's compassion is beyond compare. In Jesus, God is always making a new way for us. In Christ, you are already and always forgiven. Blessed be God forever. Our gathering hymn today is God is Here. We'll sing verses 1, 3, and 4. Let us pray together the prayer of the day. God of love, giver of life, we know our frailties and failings. Give us your grace to overcome them. Keep us from those things that harm us. and guide us in the way of salvation. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Congregation may be seated for special music from our St. Paul singers. Continue with our scripture readings this morning for this 18th Sunday after Pentecost. Thanks, Rick, for being our scripture reader.
A reading from the prophet Ezekiel, the 18th chapter. The word of the Lord came to me. What do you mean by repeating this proverb concerning the land of Israel? The parents have eaten sour grapes, and the children's teeth are set on edge. As I live, says the Lord God, this proverb shall no more be used by you in Israel. Know that all lives are mine. The life of the parent as well as the life of the child is mine. It is only the person who sins that shall die. Yet you say the way of the Lord is unfair. Hear now, O house of Israel, is my way unfair? Is it not your ways that are unfair? When the righteous turn away from the righteousness, from their righteousness, and commit iniquity, they shall die for it. For the iniquity that they have committed, they shall die. Again, when the wicked turn away from their wickedness they have committed, and do what is lawful and right, they shall save their life. Because they considered and turned away from all the transgressions that they had committed, they shall surely live. They shall not die. Yet the house of Israel says, the way of the Lord is unfair. O house of Israel, are my ways unfair? Is it not your ways that are unfair? Therefore I will judge you, O house of Israel, all of you according to your ways, says the Lord God. Repent and turn from all your transgressions. otherwise iniquity will be your ruin. Cast away from you all the transgressions that you have committed against me, and get yourselves a new heart and a new spirit. Why will you die, O house of Israel? For I have no pleasure in the death of anyone, says the Lord God. Turn then and live. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
In a reading from Psalm 25, we will read it responsively by verse. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul.
My God, I put my trust in you. Let me not be put to shame, nor let my enemies triumph over me.
Let none who look to you be put to shame. Rather, let those be put to shame who are treacherous.
Show me your ways, O Lord, and teach me your paths.
Lead me in your truth and teach me, for you are the God of my salvation. In you have I trusted all the long day.
Remember, O Lord, your compassion and love, for they are everlasting.
Remember not the sins of my youth and my transgressions. Remember me according to your steadfast love and for the sake of your goodness, O Lord.
You are gracious and upright, O Lord. Therefore, you teach sinners in your way.
You lead the lowly in justice and teach the lowly your way. Third reading is from St. Paul's letter to the Philippians, the second chapter. If then there is any encouragement in Christ, any consolation from love, any sharing in the Spirit, any compassion and sympathy, make my joy complete. Be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility, regard others as better than yourselves. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth. And every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Therefore, my beloved, just as you have always obeyed me, not only in my presence, but much more now in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. For it is God who is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for his good pleasure. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
This is a time where we're going to have our kids' message. So if Mason and Javion want to come forward. It's great having you both here today. Have you guys met each other before?
No.
Maybe this summer, I thought maybe you would. So, Mason, Javion, right? And so Javion, Mason. So it's good having you both here. How old are you?
7 1/4.
7 1/4, how old are you?
Seven.
So you guys are both the same age. So it's great having you both here. So, you remember what we do at the very end of worship when we walk back there? What do we do?
You start walking back there, and then the children, when you get to the pews, they walk out.
Mm-hmm. And what do you guys say? We say something like, we respond.
God's children say amen.
Yep, all God's children say amen. And then, what do we sometimes say after amen?
Yes.
Yes. So, we sometimes when we say amen, we do this hand motion. So it's kind of like amen is in prayer. There's another way to say amen is like this. Amen. Can you try that?
Amen.
Amen. And so it's kind of like, yes, it's true. That's why we say yes at the very end. So today Jesus is talking about ways to say yes. Because sometimes we say yes, like in our heads, like, hey, we're going to do something. But then sometimes we don't go and do it. Our bodies don't say yes. Does that ever happen? That you think you're going to do something, and then you don't do it? And then sometimes it's the other way. We say, well, I don't want to do this. I'm saying no. And then we go and do it. Has that happened to you? I know when I was a little older than you, my mom asked me, will you go get me some dessert from the table? We had a big party with all my family there. And I said, no, I don't want to, but I will go. I will do it. So there's times we say yes, and then we don't always do it. And then sometimes we say no, and then we go do it anyway. So it's what Jesus really wants us to do is say yes and go do it. So there's times like when we have to say, yes, Jesus loves me. And because, yes, Jesus loves me, I get to go and do and help other people. What's your favorite thing to do to help others? Perfect. Be kind and showing people respect. How about you? How do you like to help others, Shaven? Do you like to give hugs? Mm-hmm. And being nice? Do you like smiling? Smiling, just giving a smile to somebody can be helpful. And listening is helping. If your mom or dad or grandma and grandpa all they ask you to do something, sometimes we don't want to do it, but then we say, okay, I'll do it. Making our beds, keeping our rooms clean, all those things. And so the biggest thing always, though, first and foremost to always remember is that Jesus loves you, that he loves you so much. And then when we know we love it ourselves and Jesus loves us, then we can go out and help others and tell them that Jesus loves them too. Because we want everybody to know that yes and yes, to keep saying yes, yes, yes. So that's why we say after the amen, we say yes, because it is true. So let's say a prayer. So let's fold our hands and then say what I say. Dear God,
dear God,
thank you for loving me.
Thank you for loving me.
Help me.
Help me
to say yes,
and go and do
what I said yes I would do.
I love you, Jesus.
Help me
to tell others
that you love them too.
In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Good job. Thanks for coming up today. Please rise as you are able for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 21st chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. When Jesus entered the temple, the chief priests and the elders of the people came to him as he was teaching and said, by what authority are you doing these things?
And who gave you this authority? And Jesus said to them, I will ask you one question. If you tell me the answer, then I will also tell you by what authority I do these things. Did the baptism of John come from heaven, or was it of human origin? And they argued with one another, if we say from heaven, he will say to us, why then did you not believe? But if we say of human origin, we are afraid of the crowd, for all regard John as a prophet. So they answered, Jesus, we do not know. And he said to them, neither will I tell you by what authority I am doing these things. What do you think? A man had two sons. He went to the first and said, son, go and work in the vineyard today. He answered, I will not. But later he changed his mind and went. The father went to the second son and said the same, and he answered, I go, sir. But he did not go. Which of the two did the will of his father? They said the first. Jesus said to them, truly I tell you, the tax collectors and the prostitutes are going into the kingdom of God ahead of you. For John came to you in the way of the righteous, and you did not believe him. But the tax collectors and the prostitutes believed in him, and even after you saw it, you did not change your minds and believe in him. The gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. I have a favorite blessing that I think tells exactly what our scriptures are about today. It's short. It says, Almighty God, who has given you the will to do these things, graciously give you the strength and the compassion to perform them. It separates out the desire, the will to do God's work in the world, and the action to actually go and do God's work in the world. It's the idea of talking the talk and walking the walk. Both parts are needed, and they are both given to us by God. God shows us God's purpose, will, desire for us and for the world, and God gives us the strength and compassion to do it. Our reading from Philippians puts it this way, for it is God who is at work in you, enabling you both to will and to work for God's good pleasure. So I want to first look at what is God's good pleasure. We can see it earlier in the scripture from Philippians. It's called the Christ hymn. Paul took a hymn that was known during the time of his writing the letter and used it to explain God's good pleasure. Be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility. Regard others as better than yourselves. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and in earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God the Father. That's God's good pleasure. As one scholar wrote, it is for us to have the depth of understanding and practical wisdom to know how to act rightly, even in confusing and complex circumstances. That's what it means to have the same mind of Christ, to be willing to give up, empty ourselves, even of things that we rightly deserve. It's knowing that the cross is unjust and that life can be unjust, yet to keep on going as Jesus did, to care about God's purpose and mission above ourselves, to sacrifice our good for one who is more vulnerable or one who has greater need. To know that we are called to do justice, to love mercy and kindness, and to walk humbly with our God. Yet, it's not always easy to get beyond the will and the desire. We know this. This is part of who we are. We know we want to do this, but we can be that son that says, yes, I'll do this, and never goes to work. We can feel that blessing of knowing God's will in our life, but not feel the strength and compassion to do so. So that's why we pray. We heard it in our gathering hymn, Lord of all, of church and kingdom, in an age of change and doubt, keep us faithful to the gospel. Help us work your purpose out. Here in this day's dedication, all we have to give, receive. We who cannot live without you, we adore you, we believe. And there's a morning prayer that goes, Lord God, almighty and everlasting Father, you have brought me in safety to this new day. Preserve me with your mighty power, that I may not fall into sin nor be overcome by adversity. And in all I do, direct me to the fulfilling of your purpose through Jesus Christ, my Lord. So it can be through prayer that God gives us the strength and compassion to go out and do justice, love kindness and mercy, and walk humbly with our God. But I think it's also important to notice that our gospel story today talks about baptism being part of this journey. For those of us already baptized, we can be renewed and live into our baptism daily. Martin Luther writes, what does baptism mean for daily living? It means that our sinful self, with all its deeds, its evil deeds and desires, should be drowned through daily repentance. And that day after day, a new self should arise to live with God in righteousness and purity forever. St. Paul writes in Romans 6, we were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death. So as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might walk in newness of life. Or for any of you who haven't been baptized before, it's part of what changed the tax collectors and the prostitutes from our gospel today. That's what really changes us, like the son that says, no, I'm not going to go work, but then changes his mind and goes to work. Baptism gives us the power, gives us God's power through the Holy Spirit to not only desire to do God's good pleasure, but to also go and do it. Well, since St. Paul had used a song in his writings that we read today, I thought I would too. It's a song from the late 1990s by Stephen Curtis Chapman called The Change. I think this song says in a newer language what Martin Luther was trying to say in newer language back in the year 1529. The song goes, I've got myself a t-shirt that says what I believe. I've got letters on my bracelet to serve as my ID. I've got the necklace and the keychain, and I'm almost everything a good Christian needs. I've got the little Bible magnets on my refrigerator door, and a welcome mat to bless you before you walk across my floor. I've got Jesus bumper sticker and the outline of a fish stuck on my car. And even though this stuff's all well and good, I cannot help but ask myself, what about the change? What about the difference? What about the grace? What about forgiveness? What about a life that's showing I'm undergoing the change? Well, I've got this way of thinking that comes so naturally, where I believe the world is revolving around me. And I got this way of living that I have to die to every single day. Because if God's Spirit lives inside of me, I'm gonna live differently. I'm gonna have the change. I'm gonna have the difference. I'm gonna have the grace. I'm gonna have forgiveness. I'm gonna have a life that's showing I'm undergoing the change. And the change is never over until we see Jesus face to face. Our salvation is secure. Each and every day, we work it out with fear and trembling as we constantly strive to live into our baptism. We call it a repentant life. It's what is talked about in our first lesson when God says to turn and live. It's the way we live out, even the psalm, when we pray, show me your ways and teach me your paths. Lead me in your truth. And it's the way of the cross, as our next song says, that demands our soul, our life, and our all. Thanks be to God. So we always have a reflection question for you to think about this week. So the question today is, how has your life changed or been different because of Jesus? We continue with our hymn of the day, When I Survey the Wondrous Cross.
Together in trust and hope, we confess our faith with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Remembering the caring and generous works of God, we pray for the church, creation, and the needs of our neighbors. We put our trust in you as we pray for the church. Give bishops, pastors, deacons, and teachers the gifts of wisdom and discernment. Be with them in bold truth and faithful witness. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Lead us in your truth as we pray for creation. Empower us to look to the interests of others as we make choices that impact the environment. Summon us to be advocates for healthy waterways, habitats, and air. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Lead us in justice as we pray for those in government, the military, and other positions of authority. Give them humble and willing hearts, looking to the needs of others. We pray also for our enemies. Merciful God, receive our prayer. Trusting your goodness, we pray for all caregivers and people who are sick or suffering in any way. Give them encouragement and consolation in your presence. Be especially with those we name now aloud or in our hearts.
Lord, we pray for all those on our prayer chain, for the names listed in our bulletin this morning, for those who are suffering from COVID-19, for those who have lost loved ones to COVID-19, for healthcare workers and law enforcement officers, for the prayers upon the community prayer cross, for Ukraine, for victims of natural and human-made disasters, for our members, especially Joanne Jordan, Ashton Kiefer, Linda Knight, Myrtle Krause, Diane Krause-Kukich, for our preschool teachers and students, especially Jonathan, Theo, Nicole, Emmett, and Caden, Mrs. Lisa, and Ms. Ivan.
Merciful God, teach us your paths as we pray for this congregation. Be at work in us and unite us in your love as we labor together for the sake of the gospel. Merciful God, receive our prayer. We give thanks for all the saints who died secure in the knowledge of salvation. Keep us fearless in our faith and certain of your resurrection. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Remember us according to your steadfast love as we offer these and the prayers of our heart, trusting in your compassion made known through Jesus Christ. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
We take time to share God's peace with one another as we turn our hands into hearts. We don't pass our offering plates around the pews, but they are available to you as you leave or as you enter the sanctuary. This is the time for the ushers to bring forward the offerings. We also have online giving through our website, especially for those of you who are watching on your devices. So we do give you thanks for your offerings to support the ministry of St. Paul, and it's really just giving them back to God, and we use them in this place. We continue with our offering prayer.
God of power, God of plenty, all things belong to you. We bring your gifts to the table that all might be fed. Form us into the body of your beloved Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
We continue with a spiritual communion prayer, especially for those of you who are watching on your devices and cannot physically eat of Jesus' body or blood. Let us pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. We continue with the communion liturgy for those of us in person. For those of you who would like to take communion at your seats, this is a time to lift up your elements for blessing and consecration. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup, gave thanks, gave for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." For as often as we eat of this bread and drink from this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gathered around this table, we, your children, unite in the song, "The earth is full of your glory. The earth is full of your glory." O God, triune, you created the worlds. You uphold the living. You embrace the dead. Send forth your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Strengthen us for our journey with this meal, the body and blood of Christ. Give us a future that trusts in you and cares for your earth. Empowered by your promises, we rise from our death to praise you again. The earth is full of your glory. The earth is full of your glory. Amen and amen. Amen and amen. Lord, remember us in your love and teach us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Jesus invites you to this table. Come, eat, and live. Thanks be to God. This is a time for those of you who would like to take communion at your seats, that you take the host wafer, that this is the body of Christ given for you. Take and eat. And then the wine or the juice, the blood of Christ shed for you, take and drink. And then this is a time for those of you who'd like to come to the altar for communion. You may do so at the usher's direction. Please rise as you are able. Now may the body and the blood of our Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace now and forever. Amen.
Blessed be your name, O God, for we have feasted on your word, Jesus Christ, the joy and delight of our hearts. Strengthened by this food, send us to gather the world to your banquet, where none are left out and all are satisfied. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
And receive the blessing. The God of glory, Jesus Christ, name above all names, and the Spirit who lives in you, bless you now and forever. Amen. Our sending hymn today is God Be With You Till We Meet Again. Go in peace. God is at work in you.
Thanks be to God.
And all God's children say,
Amen.
Yes.
Thank you. I'll delete it all right?